Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be another unboxing video, but before I get to the unboxing, I'm going to show you the figures I already have first. I'm just going to move this back a little, and I'll tell you the unboxing. It is going to be the Masters of the Universe Revelations Teela unboxing. I got this for Christmas, and she was one of the only ones I wanted, and along with the three I'm going to show you before I unbox her. I did get this, and I did get the Sorceress for Christmas as well. So let me know if you want to see a video on this as well. If you do, I will definitely do one. So yeah, but I have three Revelation figures I'm going to show you first, and just want to fix this camera. So, we'll get started, and the first one I want to show you is Evil-Lyn, and I have all the packagings, but the only one I got down was Skeletor, and, we'll actually start with Skeletor first, because this is his packaging, and, here's Skeletor, and unfortunately, you have to kind of ruin the box to get it open. Now, I did originally do a video opening all of these, but for some, whatever reason, the video took so long to upload, so I just didn't upload it. So that's why I'm showing you these figures in this video for the Teela unboxing. So here's Skeletor's box. They're all pretty much the same, just different name and different artwork on the side and on the back. And if you can see that, Skeletor, move out of the way for a minute. You can pause and read the description. I know it's not the greatest camera, but there it is. And then the other figures in the wave. Now, this is the first wave. You get Evil-Lyn, Skeletor, Mothman, and He-Man. Didn't really care for Mothman or He-Man. I like them in this show, but I'm very limited on these figures. So here is Skeletor. He does come with his Havoc staff, which I think is probably the best accessory he comes with, which is pretty cool. And it's just all purple, but the ram head is pretty cool if you ask me. And he comes with another staff, which I forget what this staff is called, but I don't display him with it. I just store it in a bag away. But it's still pretty cool. It's just all gold. And then he has come with two interchangeable hands. He comes with a closed fist and a open palm. But the ones I have him, get some fur off him. The ones I have him the pegged in are the gripping ones. And this is a pretty cool figure. I like Skeletor a lot in the show. I know a lot of people didn't like Mark Hamill's voice because it was too jokery, like the Joker. But I did like him. He was probably my favorite character, him and Evil-Lyn, which I'm going to show after. I was going to show it first, but I had Skeletor's box. So I thought, right, why not show him first? So he's pretty cool. He has a soft goods cape. It's kind of just plain velvet cape, but it's still pretty cool. As you can see, and I know a lot of people didn't like the face sculpt because it's kind of a greenish color. I do like it actually. Would have been nice if it was more like the show, but it's still pretty cool. His articulation is a ball jointed head, ball hinged shoulders, swivel at the thigh, double hinged elbows, hinged wrists, swivel at the waist, hinged hips, but his little skirt thing kind of hinders it, swivel at the thigh, double hinged knees, and hinged ankle with, does he have an ankle pin? No. Doesn't have ankle pivot, but there's his articulation. The only part I don't like about this figure is this part right here, how it's not one piece. I would have preferred if it was one piece. That would have been better in my opinion. But it's still a cool figure. And you can have him holding the Havoc staff. Anyway, I like this finger because it looks like he's pointing. You want, but I like to have him holding it with both hands sometimes. If I can get it back in. But he does hold it well with just one hand. As you can see. But I like having him hold it with both hands. So, yeah. So, if I can get it in. There we are. The Havoc staff is pretty cool. I like it when Skeletor figures come out with them. So, there is the Skeletor figure. I'm just going to put him back on his base, and we will move on to the next figure. I know there's another Skeletor coming out. That's more of the classic version, which I do want to get. And so that would be pretty cool. Evil-Lyn is next, and she comes with her staff. Now, she comes with her wand when it gets cut in half. Which is pretty cool. And I like having her displayed with this. And it's just a longer version of the wand, which is a staff, pretty much. So they're pretty much the same. Just one's shorter and one's longer. She also comes with an interchangeable head, which you can take off the ball joint. And I'll put it on. I don't display her with this head, just because I like the classic hood look better. But I'll just put it on really fast if I can get it on. But so there's what that head looks like. And she has come with a satchel or a bag as well. And there's the back of the head. And she also comes with multiple different hands as well. She comes with two open hands. Like this. Like that. And she does come with two fisted hands as well. Like so. So, there is Evil-Lyn's accessories. I'm just going to take her head back off. But there's one last look at this head. And I'll put her regular head back on. And her articulation is ball-jointed head, ball-hinged shoulders, swivel at the forearm, double-hinged elbows, hinged wrists, hinged hips, swivel at the thigh, double hinged knees, and ankle movement as well. So pretty much the same articulation as Skeletor. But she's pretty cool. I do like her outfit as well. There's just a 360 look of her. And I'm always going to say this, but the hood reminds me of the Evil Queen's hood from Snow White. Just very similar. So yeah, but there is Evil-Lyn. I like to have her displayed with the long staff, even though in this show, spoilers, she doesn't really use it all that much. From what I remember, I don't think she uses it when it's a long staff. I think she, when it gets cut in half, she uses it a bit more. But I still think it's pretty cool as her holding it, because the short one can actually go back here. So that's pretty cool. So I have her with both. I have her displayed with both in a way. But there is Evil-Lyn. And I'm going to go ahead and put her on her base. So she can stand up next to Skeletor over here. And the last figure we have before we open Teela is Skull God. And the only reason I wanted him, because, spoilers again, if you haven't seen the series, go watch it, is because he is Skeletor. Skeletor turns into Skeletor God. If he didn't, I probably would have passed on him. But he's a pretty cool figure. He comes with, the sword. Oopsie. Now, unfortunately, he comes with the power sword, I believe. That's what it's called. And unfortunately, his hands don't stay in good, so this part comes off easily. And he comes with a fire, green fire effect as well. As well as an alternate hand, too. So let me put this back on, and let me put this sword. Back in place. And he's pretty cool. His cape is a little different than Skeletor's regular cape. It's actually layered, which I do like that. And it has some jewels, I guess that's what they're supposed to be. Not really sure. And I do like his face. I think it's very cool. And his articulation is a ball-jointed head as well. Ball hinge shoulders. Double hinge at the elbows. Hinge at the wrists. Hinge at the hips, swivel at the thighs, double hinge knees, and double an ankle pivot along with hinged ankle as well. So he has a little bit more articulation than Skeletor, because Skeletor did not have ankle pivot from what I could tell on the figure. So he's pretty cool, and I'm going to go ahead and put him on his base. He barely stands on it, but it's okay because he's a big figure. And if you go to Target right now, these figures were on sale. So if you go to Target, they might still be on sale. I think this guy was like for $20, and I think the regular figures were like for $15.99. So that's a pretty good deal. So there is Skeletor God. So there are all the figures. Now we're gonna open Teela. And I like Teela. She was voiced by Sarah Michelle Gellar in the show. And I liked her a lot. And, so here is the packaging. There is Masters of the Universe Revelations Teela. There is Teela on the side. There is artwork of her on the side. And there is a read-up. If you want to pause and read that, you can. You can see that. And then there's more artwork as well. And the other figures you can get. And in Series 2, there is Man-at-Arms, Teela, Beastman, and Spikor. So there is that. So, pretty cool. And then there's the bottom. So, what I'm going to do, if I can find the scissors I was just using. Oh, here they are. I'm going to open Teela. Now, I probably should have opened the other figures like this because I could have saved the boxes, but I destroyed them, so I thought better. So, her accessories, it looks like she comes with this staff spear thing. It's a little warped from being in the packaging. She comes with two hands, which I will have to switch out if this will come out. She comes with a gripping hand and an open hand, which I will have to switch out comes with this little device. Not sure what it's called. If you remember what this is called, you know, it kind of looks like, it kind of looks like a lightsaber, but it's not. And she comes with her sword-looking device. I think, like this. I forgot what it was called as well. So let's get Teela out. Sorry, that was pretty loud. Sorry if that hurt your ears. And she's in a pre-pose already, but we're gonna just destroy that pose because I want her standing up straight. And she's pretty cool. She's very muscular. And I'm probably going to have her displayed with this, even though it's a little warped, but it is a softer plastic, so. So yeah. And, in the box, she comes with a fisted hand. So I'm actually going to take that off. If I can. Yep. There's the fisted hand. And I'm gonna put the gripping hand, replace that, so she can hold her weapon. Okay, there we are. So she can hold her weapons. And, but first let's go ahead and take a look at her details. She has a little pouch right there. It can't open or anything. At least I don't think. No, it can't open or anything. It looks like this part can go in here. So that's cool. I might display her with both accessories. And, wasn't a huge fan of the hairstyle, but she was still a cool character. And I do like her vest details. There is another Teela coming out, and it is a classic Teela. And I like that one much better. And I'm going to definitely get that one and the classic Skeletor, so. And you can see the belt that goes all the way around. And the gold belts around her legs. And her boots as well as her knee pads too. And we'll just go over her articulation. She has a ball jointed head, ball hinged shoulders, swivel at the forearm, double hinged elbows, swivel at the waist, hinge hips, swivel at the thigh, double hinge knees, yep, double hinge knees, and hinge at the ankle. So the same articulation as Evil Lyn. But there is Teela. Now let's put some accessories in her hand if I can do that. I'm kneeling on the floor, so my feet are fast asleep right now. So there's one accessory. And we'll go ahead and put the other accessory in her hand as well. If it will go in her hand. So, alright, there it is. So, there's the other accessory as well. So, pretty cool. I like it. It doesn't really stay in her hand all that well, so I'm going to take it out. But, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and give her a base as well. And, so let me know which figure you like the best. Do you like Skeletor, Evil Lyn, Teela, or... Scale God the best, and let me know your thoughts on that down below. And that's gonna do it for this video, and until the next video, I'll see you guys later. Please check out my Instagram page where I do daily postings, And please subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys later. Bye.